guys, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to show you one of our favorite family recipes. It doesn't really have a name, but it's a chicken recipe, and maybe I'll come up with a name for it someday. But it's basically just a baked chicken recipe, and it's so easy that a kid can help you do it. Normally I remember to thaw my chicken out early, but I forgot today, so I had to thaw it out in the microwave. So part of it I've already done for Mackenzie, but normally I would let Mackenzie do the whole thing beginning to end, except for putting things in the oven. But other than that, I am going to let Mackenzie show you how to make it.
Hi guys, so today I am making chicken
and
potatoes. So first you put the chicken into the pan, but my mom already helped me with that. So, well, because it was too hot, because it just came out of the microwave, so. Okay, the next step is you take your, you get your chicken and you roll your chicken around in the breadcrumbs, so.
These are Italian style breadcrumbs. Sometimes we use these, sometimes we just buy plain breadcrumbs from the store, and we will season them with salt, pepper, garlic powder, and onion powder. But today we cheated and bought the already seasoned kind.
Okay, this one is all good. Set that one in there, get the next chicken. It's dripping. This smells like pizza, like the garlicky pizza.
Look at Kenzie's cool chef hat.
I'm rocking it. Okay, number two is done. Fourth one is done.
Okay, there's not enough breadcrumbs on them, so now I want you to take some from the bowl and just make sure each piece of chicken has plenty of breadcrumbs all over the top, okay?
It's snowing. I love making chicken. Should I just dump the rest in there?
Sure, why not? Is there a lot left?
No.
Okay, just dump it in. Okay, spread it out evenly over the chicken. I see a corner over here on your left, closest to me, that has no breadcrumbs.
Over here?
That's your right.
Sorry, I get confused with my right and my left.
It's still there. It's gonna bother me. Right there, yes.
I'm massaging the chicken.
Ew. Okay, that's good. Now Mackenzie's going to go wash her hands because she's been touching raw chicken.
Plus I'm massaging it.
You're so awkward.
The next step is pour melted butter, which my mom already melted because I decided I wanted to do the video too. So some of the steps are already done. And so then anyway, you pour the melted butter on all over the chicken evenly. So let's get started.
Try and make it even. Good job.
Come on. We got done here. So my mom is going to go put this in the oven because I'm not allowed to use hot stuff.
Like ovens?
Like ovens. Plus I'm scared of ovens. So I don't know how I'm gonna cook when I'm older. But okay. You need to set it at 350 degrees and for about an hour to an hour 30 minutes.
Depending on how big the chicken is and how frozen your chicken might be. In our case, a lot of times it's a little more frozen than it should be when we start cooking it. So we cook it anywhere from an hour to an hour and a half.
So I scooted my chicken off to the side. That's over with. Next we're gonna do baked potatoes, which I never made before. So this is gonna be fun. And my mom's gonna have to tell me each and everything to do. Yay!
Okay, bring your potatoes over. And here's your foil. Okay.
What do I do?
First, you're gonna pick up one of the potatoes that I've already rinsed, and you're gonna pick up the fork, and you're gonna stab your potato. You wanna cut. Okay. I want at least one set of holes on each side of the potato. So at least like four holes all around the potato.
Wait, right here?
Just a few sets of holes around the potato. It's not really too...
One hole. Two holes. I should be a comedian. Three hole.
Are you putting it in deep enough so that it's making little holes?
Four hole. Okay. Here's the potato.
Okay, keep going.
Where do I put it?
Okay, whoa. Are you done with that?
Kids, I don't know.
Are you done with that potato?
I don't know.
Could you put some holes all over it?
I'm still putting it.
Okay, I think that's good. Stop.
Wait, the other side.
Stop.
Done.
Okay, now you're going to set it on top of the top piece of foil. And you're going to wrap it up in a blanket so it's all covered.
The potato won't breathe.
That's okay. We don't want it to breathe.
Well, that's me.
That's why we gave it air holes. So it doesn't explode in the oven.
That would be cool.
You wrap it up really tight. Everything super tight, all the way around.
Look, it's a gift. With hair.
Potatoes are the best kind of gift, I'm just saying.
All right. Except for bacon.
Oh, yeah, except for bacon. Maybe we'll add some bacon to our potatoes.
Ew. That actually sounds kind of good. I don't know.
Some bacon bits?
I got one.
Okay.
foil. And so, you're gonna, you're gonna put it in the oven for an hour an hour and 30 minutes. Or however big the chicken or the potatoes are. And so, yeah. Bye.
Jesse, I just want to warn you in case you watch this. Mackenzie, while covering the potatoes with foil, informed me that she is going to be the chef at your wedding. So, good luck to all of us who eat at your wedding.
Oh, I'm a good chicken maker. Sometimes potatoes. Well, I never made them, but... Okay, bye. As you can see, our dinner is done, and now we're going to eat it. I hope it's good. It's delicious. Bye.
Hot.
Is it good?
Yeah.
Did you do a good job?
Yeah.
Good stuff, huh?
Thank you.
Nom nom.
My kids don't eat like they should. They just poke it with the fork and hold it up to chew it off.
Wait, that's not how we're supposed to...
for making this lovely dinner. You're welcome, Mackenzie.